There are numerous examples of breakthroughs that humans have used or discovered in their existence that have catapulted us to the top of the food chain. The wheel, the steam engine, the printing press, etc. These advances are known to most people, and we realize that without those things existing, we'd still probably be in the Dark Ages. But there are also a lot of little blips on the timeline throughout human history of simpler things between the lines. These technologies may not have the same luster as the heavy hitters, but if you try to imagine your daily life without these things being developed and perfected, you would quickly see that they're every bit as important. In the video today, we're looking at some simple technologies that changed the world in profound ways. Number 10. Duct tape. That sticky gray tape that seems to hold most of the world together these days draws its history all the way back to the Second World War. The military used the tape to keep their ammunition boxes sealed, but quickly found that there were tons of other uses for it. What began as a medical tape was found to have incredible adhesive qualities as well as inherent waterproofing, which led to soldiers calling it duct tape, referring to a duck's wicking feathers. Once the war ended, soldiers returned home and began buying houses en masse. They also took lots of jobs with construction companies and told their bosses about this incredible sticky tape they'd used during the war. The tape was used for all sorts of HVAC applications, but mostly for holding ductwork together. So duct tape became duct tape, but in 1998, a test of common HVAC sealing materials was conducted, and duct tape, well, it came in dead last. Number 9. Teflon pans. When scientists in the 1930s developed a new kind of polymer that was superbly heat-resistant and uber-slippery, they used it in war because, well, that's what was going on at the time. It took all the way until the 1960s until they decided it would be great for keeping food from sticking to pans. And it wasn't just pans. The non-stick coating known as Teflon changed the home kitchen for good and also began being applied to muffin and cake tins as well as cookie sheets. Cleanup was a breeze. The coating could handle high heat. The only thing it was kind of bad at was not killing people. The workers that produced Teflon were basically poisoned by the material, and that sickness was passed on to Lord knows how many consumers. One of the components in Teflon that was responsible wasn't banned until 2014. Number 8. Smoke detectors. If you think of all the things that you take for granted in your home today, smoke detectors are probably going to be somewhere near the top of that list. Those little gadgets have saved countless lives, yet you probably hardly notice them until their batteries run low. They've become standard and required in homes these days, so it's hard to imagine a time when they weren't around. And, well, they happened by accident. In the 1930s, a scientist in Switzerland was trying to make a device that detected poison gas in the air. While it failed to pick up the presence of the tested poison when he lit a cigarette, the smoke did trip the alarm. It took until the late 1960s before they found their way into homes, and they've cut fire-related deaths by half. Number 7. Viagra. A little blue pill that's only been around for 20 years shouldn't have had such an impact on the world that it's had, especially since it's not cured any major disease. Instead, it's just let men experience the wonder of full erections. But Viagra really has changed sex around the world. In 1991, testing began on what would become Viagra, but it was developed with the intention of lowering blood pressure. But during the studies, there was a certain side effect that the men could not ignore. The development of the drug headed in the direction of restoring sexual health to men, and within 10 years, 200,000 prescriptions a week were being filed. It changed the way men confronted diminishing sex drives. It also helped unknown diseases related to erectile dysfunction become treated when men came to the doctor seeking Viagra. Number 6. Credit cards. A fixture of almost every wallet, the credit card is simultaneously boosting the economy and bankrupting countless people who don't have any financial acumen. The concept of pay us later, we're sure you're good for it, and then tacking on insane interest amounts is actually a fairly new concept, at least in card form. But they're ubiquitous now, and there are around 18 billion of them in use. In 1949, businessman Frank McNamara was at a restaurant and realized he'd forgotten his wallet. This made him envision a kind of card that could be used at multiple businesses. He started Diners Club the next year, and within the next decade, more and more banks started making their own credit cards. Fast forward to the present day, and Americans alone possess over $1 trillion in credit card debt. So yes, in less than 100 years, we've done some pretty major damage. Number 5. UPC codes. You've seen that little box of black lines on the side of every product you buy, even more so when you're struggling to find them in the self-checkout line. The UPC code, it gets scanned, the price shows up, and it's a pretty expedient process. But, well, how did it get to become the norm? In 1948, Joseph Woodlands, who'd actually worked on the Manhattan Project, was responding to a query from a local store owner about how to speed up the process of buying products in his store. Woodlands thought about Morse code and its simple way of giving lots of information with dots and lines, so he used that as his inspiration. His innovation could describe an item and its price all at once, instead of at the snail's pace of non-automated operations that most stores suffered through. The only thing that held back progress was the lack of computers readily available to read the code, so it took until 1974 until the technology began to roll out nationwide. Number 4. Barbed wire. Two problems faced the American West as it grew and expanded. Cattle were getting loose and trampling precious crops, and there wasn't enough wood in those regions to build fences. The Homestead Act of 1862 made it so many people could get vast tracts of land for next to nothing, so it was important that they were able to work that land and have secure properties. Enter into the picture Joseph Glidden of Illinois, who patented barbed wire in 1874. It wasn't without its growing pains, as the wire trapped dumb cows by the thousands, and cowboys hated their herds being restricted by the artificial borders. And it was these very borders that marked a person's property and screwed over the Native Americans, as these practices left them even fewer claims to their ancestral lands. The Homestead Act required that a person build a home and work the land for 5 years before it would become their own. The barbed wire was a metaphorical and physical realization that their way of life, it was over. Number 3. Velcro. Zippers were still very much the rage in 1941 when Swiss engineer George de Mestral came up with an idea while walking his dog in the woods. He noticed how his clothing and dog were covered in sticky burrs, the pointy little things that always prick your fingers when you're removing them. Under a microscope, he saw how the curved hooks of the burrs met his clothing in an almost perfect marriage. And just like that, zippers were no longer the only game in town. Zippers tended to jam all the time, but Velcro didn't have that problem. Though originally implemented in clothing, it's now used in everything from sporting equipment to NASA spacecraft. And, well, whoever began using it in clothing for children should absolutely get a medal. Number 2. Daylight saving time. Okay, so maybe not exactly a technology, but the advent of daylight saving time has changed a lot about our modern world. First started in Germany in 1916 as a way to enjoy the sunshine and to conserve electricity, it began to catch on in other countries around the world soon after. In the United States, it was started in 1918 as a wartime practice. It was repealed the next year after farmers protested. The next few decades saw back and forth fighting and different start times for daylight saving across the country. Finally, in 1966, the Uniform Time Act made, well, time uniform across the country. The central concept, energy conservation, doesn't really seem to be a benefit, though. The stuff that uses the most electricity in our homes are the things that get used more when we are home, if that makes sense. It seems that the money that gets boosted into the economy by people enjoying more leisure daytime in the evening is enough to keep the practice in use. Number 1. Transistors. Think of the devices that power your everyday life. Smartphones, computers, tablets, etc. They all have one thing in common at their very core, and that is the simple transistor. The development of the transistor signaled the developmental shift from hardware to software, and it's why technology has surged light years ahead since its inception. A transistor is merely a type of semiconductor that either amplifies signals or switches them. Invented in 1947, it was a device far ahead of its time, and as computing devices grew and became more efficient, so too did the transistor. Computers got smaller and became household items, while transistors shrunk down to the size of a few nanometers. Those tiny transistors are one of the only unchanged building blocks of the entire digital age. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below and don't forget to subscribe. We got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. For more from me, why not check out my other channel called Geographics? I'm going to link to that below. And as always, thank you for watching.